Howdy guys, it's Liv here from Neighbourhood. Are you looking to remove the back and forth hassle of trying to organise a meeting with someone? Well, today we hope to solve that by setting up meeting links inside HubSpot. Now remember, if you're keen on learning more with Neighbourhood, we actually offer a comprehensive and easy to follow course so that you're making the absolute most out of your HubSpot investment. Stay tuned for more information at the end of this video. As well, if you're wanting to take your learning offline, we'll include a downloadable PDF in the description bar below. Okay guys, so here we are in the meeting links tool. To get here, I've gone up to the main navigation, up to sales and down to meetings, as meetings is essentially what we like to call a sales enablement tool, allowing you to sell easier and better. In here, you can see the option to connect your calendar. There'll be a separate video about how to do this. It's very similar to connecting social accounts, an ad account, anything like that, even your email. But in here, you can see all of the different meeting links that you currently have set up. Something to note is that no one person should have a singular meeting link. I'm sure all of the different meetings that you have day to day, no one is ever the same. However, you may have different types of meetings, things like perhaps discovery calls, internal powwows, that kind of thing. You can create meeting links for those different types of meetings. And the reason why we do this is so that you can ask different questions of people booking meetings with you so that you have some qualifying information before you go into that meeting, allowing you to sell better, as I said. So let's go up to that orange button up to create a scheduling page. Now in here, you can choose a specific type of meeting. In here, you have just a one-on-one, clues in the name, obviously just you and that person. You could also have a group meeting where HubSpot will scan the calendars of you and perhaps the rest of your marketing team or the rest of your sales team, or a round robin meeting where it will do that same thing, scan all of your calendars and basically just see who is available so that someone is able to chat to someone sooner. In this case, let's just do it for the sake of a one-on-one meeting. So we'll click on one-on-one, and in here, we are gonna create the overview of what this meeting is. So the internal name for this might be discovery call. In here, we're gonna add in the organizer. In that case, it's me. Now the title is what the recipient is going to see. So in this case, discovery call meeting link, for example, give them a little bit more information. In here, we can also include personalizations. We could add in a contact token, for example, with first name, or even a company token too. First name from company name, like that. In here as well, we can also add in a location. So if all of your meetings happen to be in an office, you could add in your physical location. However, you can also add in a video conference link like Zoom. In this case, you'll need to connect Zoom as an integration, as an app. So ensure that you do that if that's the case. As well, we can also add in a description of the meeting. So what's going to be covered in our discovery call? We could add in some dot points, things to remember before attending the meeting, what you need to bring, what coffee they like, that kind of thing. You can include it all in there. We'll then go to next into scheduling. Now, this is really important as all of our calendars, I'm sure, on Mondays fill up really, really quickly. So you want to ensure that people are only booking times with you that suit you. So in here, you're able to say the duration options for the types of meetings or the lengths of meetings that people can book with you. In this case, we could say 30 minutes, an hour, or an hour and 30 minutes. Maybe they're your only options for discovery calls, or perhaps for this specific type, it's just an hour. You'll also add in your time zone, super important for universal clients, but also adding in an availability window. So you might say, in the case of me, I don't like doing meetings with my clients on Mondays as I usually have a lot of internal stuff to get done. So I might remove this entirely as an option from my scheduling page. I may also keep Friday afternoons off. So I may just change my hours here from 12 p.m. to 5 p.m. In the additional settings area as well, you have the option to set a minimum notice time. So in this case, you'll need 15 minutes before someone books a meeting with you. You could change this to a couple of days, a week. You also have buffer time. So for example, in an afternoon, your entire afternoon is free, and you want to make sure that you definitely have an hour increment between each meeting, you can set that buffer time. You also have the option in here for start time increment as well. So setting the frequency of your meeting's start times. So basically ensuring that your meetings are working as well for your customers as they are for you. We can then move on to the form. So in here, this is where we can glean some information from our contacts before we actually speak to them. So in this case, for a discovery call, we might want to know what their inquiry is about, perhaps what product they have, maybe what company they're from. So in this case, we could even go in here and look up company size as an example. And we can add that in, and we can ask this question of people. One thing to note as well is that you're able to add in, obviously, a contact property if you're looking to add in information in here that's relevant to your contact card. However, you also have the option to ask custom questions. So if it's not necessarily things that you want to save as data on a contact card, it might just be something random to do with the meeting, you can add in that custom question there and get that information before the meeting starts. Now we'll go over to next. And in here, we can set up automation. So here we can say that we want to send a confirmation email to attendees immediately after they schedule a meeting so that they have that in their inbox so that they're aware that they've actually booked it. But we could also set up a pre-meeting reminder. Super important. If I tick this button here, we can say that we can schedule that reminder email for an hour before, but we can change this to a week before, a day before, or even a couple of minutes before. I would recommend doing it the day before, as well as perhaps half an hour before, just to keep people across their calendar. And that's that. We'll go down to this orange button down the bottom, we'll go create scheduling page, and you'll see in a second, if I go in and click on this link, this is what I'm met with. You can see the days that I'm available here, the times that I'm available, and then you can go through, add in your information, and book that meeting with me. And here you have the meeting link, the scheduling page itself. You can see the days that I'm available, the times that I'm available to chat. You'll just be able to go in, fill out that form, and then request to book a meeting with me. And it's as easy as that. And there you have it. You now know how to set up a meeting link inside HubSpot. If you're really keen to make the absolute most out of your HubSpot investment, Neighbourhood offer a step-by-step course covering marketing, sales, service, and CMS Hub in depth, ensuring that you and your team are best serving your customers while providing efficient internal processes. We'll include a link for this down below. As well, if you got any value from this video at all, or are keen to learn more about HubSpot, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And don't forget, if you're after a PDF version of this for later, or you're just passing it on to a mate in need, we'll include a link in the description.